Okay. Good deal. Well, hi, everyone.
Hello.
Thank you for coming. Kids, do you want to wave to your parents? I'm not sure where everybody is. But yeah, it is great to see all of you, and I'm so thrilled that you could all take time off work or rearrange your schedules to be here today. And the kids have been working really hard doing an we call it an informance. And an informance is like a music performance, but instead of going on stage, we are going to be inviting the parents into the classroom to perform for you guys the kinds of things and activities that we do each week in music class. So make yourself at home, we will get started. Kids, let's stand up. All right. We are going to start today by warming up our singing voices. So, kids, if you will echo me. This is my speaking voice.
This is my speaking voice.
This is my loud voice.
This is my loud voice.
This is my robot voice.
This is my robot voice.
This is my monster voice.
To stand up, because I don't want the kids to sing with their backs to you. So if you would like, you're more than welcome to come up to the front. The kids are still gonna need to see the screen, but you're welcome for just the next two songs here. We'll stand over here and over here in front, and in front of my piano is fine too. All right. Great, sorry about that. But okay. Next, we're gonna do a warm-up using a roller coaster. So if you can kind of see on the screen over there, I've got a little roller coaster. And what the kids are gonna do is they're gonna use their singing voices to follow along with that roller coaster car. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Good job. Let's make it a little bit more interesting. A little bit longer. Let's follow this one. How about a little ramp off the end of it?
Yeah!
Okay, here we go.
I love this one.
All right, here it is. Well, that wasn't very nice. We need to give it a landing pad to fall on. So we'll finish it off and bring that roller coaster back up to the top. Good job. Kids, you want to do it one more time really fast?
Yeah!
All right, super duper fast. Here we go. This is our last little warm-up. Ready? Go! Nice job, kids. All right, Madison, I need your help. Can you come up here? Will you be my remote person? Hit this button here when we get to when we sing each picture, okay? Okay, you can go back to your spot. All right, up next we have a song to sing you, parents. So, this is called Hello World, and it's kind of cute. So, I hope you enjoy, okay? All right, Madison, hit it.
Yeah.
go back to your seats now. You know, this is a pretty special thing we're doing because these first graders, for the very first time, are getting to perform music in front of an audience. And that can be kind of a, I don't know, it can be a little bit of a scary thing to perform in front of an audience. But I tell you, it's really great to use an experience like this to in a safe place to kind of get used to performing in front of people, even sometimes people we don't know. So parents, don't you think they're doing a good job? Let's give them one more big round of applause. Yeah. Good job, kids. So, well, in music class, we talk a lot about these things called the pillars of music. And there are four pillars of music. These are the four things that really make music work.
They're pillars.
Right? Yeah, they're the pillars of music. So we've got the steady beat, the rhythm, the melody, and the harmony. Now in first grade, we tackled the first three pillars already. The steady beat, the rhythm, and the melody. And during today's informants, we are going to do an activity for each of these, starting with the steady beat. So let's all say our definition of steady beat together, kids. Ready? Go.
The steady beat is a pulse that stays the same speed.
That's right. Steady beats don't speed up and they don't slow down. They stay the same speed. And we've got a fun activity for all of you today called beat motion. So students, if you will go find a spot on the circle.
I do.
All right, in this activity, each student's gonna get a chance to be the leader, okay? And I'm gonna use this arrow to show which student is leading at each particular time. Kids, think of a motion that you can perform on the beat. Okay, and we're gonna play a little song. While we do, the kids will be watching the leader and performing their motion. All right? Students, are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, get all started, all right?
I'm
Well done, kids. All right, back to your seats. Back to your seats.
And I didn't have to do that because I was on.
Yeah,
I was already on my.
Great job leading, friends. All right. Cool. Okay, guys. Our next pillar of music is the rhythm. So let's define rhythm together. The rhythm is
the long and short notes and rest that fit inside the beat.
We've been talking a lot about rhythms this year. The kids can actually identify quite a few of these. So let's start with the first one we learned, and that is called a
quarter note.
Good, and a quarter note gets how many beats?
One.
One beat, and what does it say, friends?
Ta.
Good, how about our next rhythm up there?
Quarter rest.
Quarter rest also gets how many beats?
One.
And the motion we do is, see, rests don't make sounds. Rests are silent, so we just go. Good job. How about this one? What's that called?
Two-eighth notes.
These are short notes, so you can actually fit two of them inside of how many beats?
One beat.
And what do they say?
T-T.
Good. And how about this one here?
One-eighth note.
Yeah, so if we took two-eighth notes and cut it in half, we would get one-eighth note. And how many beats does one-eighth note get?
One.
Yeah, it gets half a beat. And instead of saying TT, it just says T. Good. And this one is called a
half note.
And a half note gets how many beats?
Two.
Two beats. Let's do the motion. Ready? Go.
Ta.
Nice. Now this guy right here looks like a hat. It's actually called a
half rest.
And yes, we call this rest and the note before it a half. But that doesn't mean it gets half a beat. It means it gets half of four beats. In music, oftentimes we're doing things in measures with four beats. So how many beats is half of four beats?
Two.
Two beats, okay? And our motion is?
Two.
Yes, because rests are silent. And this note right here, what's that called?
A whole note.
And a whole note gets how many beats?
Four.
Yeah, it gets the whole thing, the whole four beats. And our motion is, ready, go.
Ta.
For four beats. Same thing with the, what is this called?
Whole rest.
Whole rest, it gets how many beats?
Four.
That's your motion, ready, go. Awesome. So parents and families, I'm just trying to paint a picture for you of what we've been learning this year. We've learned about each of these rhythms, and now we're gonna put them together in an activity called Rhythm Cards. So kids, clap and count nice and strong. Here we go. Beat, beat.
Thank you.
this is even at first grade, we're learning how to read music. Okay? Reading music is almost like learning a different language, isn't it?
Yep.
It has symbols, and we
when
can use those symbols
to
communicate ideas. And we'll go to level 8 another time, okay?
Yeah.
We love going up a level. So, all right, you guys are doing great. Let's move on now to our third pillar of music. I know that might get old for the parents, but it never gets old for me. The melody. So let's define melody together. The
melody is the high and low pitches that fit inside the beat.
Good job. See, melody isn't just like rhythm where it's talking about the length of the note. Now we're exploring the fact that some notes or pitches are higher than others. We use a system called solfege to do this, and some of the grown-ups in here might remember this from when they were kids in music class. But we have some body signs for solfege. So kids, let's stand up and let's show our families where on your body is do. Yeah, do's on our knees. Where's re? And mi, fa, so, la, ti, and hi do. Now, let's sing a little song. I bet some of you will recognize this from the Sound of Music. This is Do, Re, Mi. Start doing melody cards. And in this, we're going to be reading melodies in three different levels. Level one uses the pitches so and mi. Now here's the thing. Every time we do anything with melodies, we have to ask ourselves a very important question, which is,
where is do?
Well, I'm glad you asked, kids. You see, do can go anywhere I tell it to go. We call it movable do, all right? Because it can go low or it can go high or anywhere in between. But once we know where do is, we can figure out where every other pitch is, going straight up this five-line music step. Now here, our first pitch is what, friends?
So.
So, and where's so on your body again? That's right, on top of our head. And our next pitch is?
Me.
Me, which is where? On your shoulders. All right. Good job. Now look at this one. We're going to change it just a little bit. This one. Notice what changed. Where it starts. Good. And let's double those up. Great job. So that was level one. Now level two, we're gonna add the pitch la.
Okay, so kids, where's Law on your body? Yep, right above your head, okay? Now in our first one, Doe's in the same place, so that means we're gonna start on what pitch, kids?
Doe!
So everyone put your hands on your head, let's try it. This one. All right. Change it up a little bit. This in this level, we're using the pitches do, re, and mi. All right. Look at your first card, kids. What's it start on?
Mi.
Mi, and then it moves to
re,
and then it does
do.
Good job. All right. Let's see with the piano. For a second, kids.
We'll get to level four.
All right, you guys are doing great. I really think that it's so cool having so many families here in the room with us today, and it's kind of interesting to know that instruments also have families, and we group these families into these big groups of musicians called orchestras. And I've been teaching the kids that there are four families of the orchestra. We've got the string family, the woodwind family, the brass family, and the percussion family. Now, I bet that most of our audience noticed when you came into the classroom today that I love instruments. And most of the instruments in my classroom are actually percussion instruments. Now, a percussion instrument is any instrument that you play by hitting. So maybe you use a drumstick, a mallet, or your hands to play on percussion instruments. And we group percussion instruments into two different kinds. We have unpitched percussion instruments. And these are all instruments that make sounds. So like cymbals, how they clang, or drums, how they go boom, right? Or triangles go ding, okay? Those are all unpitched percussion instruments. We also have pitched percussion instruments. And these are all the xylophones, the tarophones, that have notes, and so that's how we group our percussion instruments. And we have a song for you today on each type of percussion instrument, starting with our unpitched percussion instruments. Now, when I taught this piece, we started with a poem. The poem's called What They Said. And in this poem, I've broken it up into two different groupings, okay? We have the blue words and the red words. Now, to start, I'm going to speak the blue words, and kids, I want you to simply speak the red words. You don't need to clap, just speak the red words, all right? Here we go. I'll keep a beat. Me first. Here we go. Still dark.
Said the lark.
Want to sleep.
Said the sheep.
Of course.
Said the horse.
Let's have tea.
Said the bee.
In the house.
Said the mouse.
Good. Now let's switch. Kids, I want you to say the blue words and I'll say the red words. And one, two, ready, go.
Still dark.
Said the lark.
Want to sleep.
Said the sheep.
Of course,
said the horse.
Let's
bee.
In the house.
Said the mouse. Now that's how I introduced the poem to the kids. But now, let's take it up a step. This time, I want you to clap the rhythm while you speak the word, okay? And you know, I'm gonna even make it one step harder than that. I'm gonna split the class right down this line here. I want you kids over here to be the blue group. Yeah, you can scoot over one if that helps. That's fine. And you guys over here will be the red group.
Red.
So you've got the blue group over here, the red group over here. That's fine. Yeah, sure. And this time, clap.
Okay.
So that group over there starts it. And one, two, let it go.
Still dark.
But this time, take away the words. Think the words and just clap. Okay? Starting with this group over here again. Well, one, two, ready, go. Make it more interesting, right? It's time to add our unpitched percussion instrument. So if you're on this side over here, I want you to come up and grab a tubano drum with a pair of jingle bells.
What are jingle bells?
And if you're in this group over here, I want you to get two things. You'll pick up your jingle bells and play with the rhythm stick. Alright? So first instruments first. And have the drums and the jingle sticks. You guys can go back to saying the words, okay? Speak the words as you play. That group starts.
Wait, all together.
Hold on guys, we'll do the rhythm of the words, okay? Two, one, two, ready, go. Piece of the informants. on the mallet instruments, we'll be performing the mallet instrument song. Kids, before I let you go find your instrument, I want to explain how this piece is going to work. We're going to start by singing the words. Then you're going to finger and say the letters. The third time through will be just the wooden instruments. The fourth time through will be just the metal instruments. And the fifth time through will be everyone together. Parents, this piece comes from a book called Music for Children. And this book was written back in the 1960s, and it was really foundational because it showed that kids could do more than just sing in music class. And I don't know what your experience was when you came to music class as a kid, but when I came to music class, we sat in desks and we opened textbooks and we sang songs. And so it looks a lot different today, and a lot of that has to do with this kind of movement that started in the 60s but really has taken off more recently than that, called the ORF approach to music education. And it's called that because one of the guys who wrote this book is a composer named Carl ORF. And so we're going to hear, this will be our grand finale, the kids performing one of his pieces that I've added words to, calling it the Mallet Instrument Song. Kids, you can go find an instrument. Sorry, don't stampede anyone. Looks like we need a couple more kids to head to one of those xylophones back there.
You're still in it.
All right, so kids, one more time. We're singing first, then we're speaking the notes, then the woods only. Our wooden instruments are called xylophones. Then our metal instrument with metal instruments, which are metallophones and glockenspiels. And everyone together, singing the words. And one, two, ready, sing.
Xylophones are telephones. Glockenspiels. Xylophones, telephones, glockenspiels. These are all mallet instruments. Xylophones, telephones, glockenspiels.
And now with your fingers, say the letters. Ready.
Thank you.
kids. That is not easy. It sounded great. Kids, you can go back to your seats now. I want to just say thank you to everyone one more time for coming today. We're so glad you get to share what we do every week.
I was staring at your mom the whole time.
Now, I know that not everybody was able to come today. It's hard to have a music performance in the middle of the day or even in the middle of the morning. And so, for that reason, thank you to Mrs. Graham for taking a video for all of us. And I will be posting that to my YouTube channel in the next couple of days. So if you would like to see that video or share that video with grandma or grandpa or someone who wasn't able to be here today and would like to see it, my channel is called Bowtie Music. Can you remember that? I'm a bowtie. So if you type in Bowtie Music, you'll find this performance today. And then I'll try and send that link home too in a Friday flyer coming up soon as well. So let's hear it for these kids just one more time. And now I'll invite you guys to check out their artwork for the art show, all right? And the art show will be right out here in the hallway in just a minute. So thank you again for coming. Kids, go give your parents a hug and tell them they love you, all right?